Hello friends, welcome to Talk a Topic. I am Harihar. Today here we have a topic that about our economy. You know, the cost of the lockdown is pegged at about $120 billion in this pandemic. In the world, we are running with a rock path, means the warlike situation is going to happen. The complete 21-day shutdown is directly impact in our demand and supply side elements of our sectors. The cost of the lockdown is pegged at around $120 billion, or we can say it 9 lakh crore or 4% of GDP. Friends, this lockdown will affect over 45 million migrants who are daily earning out of work. Remember, 90% of India's workforce is employed in the unorganized sector. Sectors like construction projects, mobility services, housekeeping, and other informal sector. The manufacturing sector faces a triple challenge. Here I am explaining. First one is there are going to serious supply chain disruption, not just when dealing with foreign parties, but also the our domestic industry. Second one is sectors like automobiles, pharmaceutical, electronics, chemical product, etc. are facing an imminent raw material and a component shortage. And third one is shutdown of loss of revenue in the cause of a number of bankruptcy and closure, essentially in the MSME sector, micro, small and medium enterprises. Then in the case of the demand side, where the several industries would get impacted, starting with the consumer durable goods. Consumer durable goods means they are automobile, books, household goods, sports equipment, jewelry, medical equipment, etc. And also in intermediate good and also basic goods. The government has also major spend on investment in the infrastructure sector, which will shut down now with resources and although being diverted. Hence, industries like steel and cement, which did well in last year. The services sector also will see a fall in demand. These include aviation, hotels, restaurant, tourism, retail malls, etc. Even 10-20% job losses among its 7.3 million employers in restaurant across the country would mean up to 15 lakh unemployed. Here the SICI, means the Southern India Chamber of Commerce and Industry, has suggested to RBI that it has to address two problems. First one is inadequate transmission of red cards, and second one is red cards by themselves are unlikely to stimulate demand as the primary cause for demand contraction. On electronic component of semiconductor industry, the impact will be felt in the areas of logistics, packaging, highly skilled industry. The government could lend support through tax holidays and zero interest loan for 3 months to the contract worker who are being deployed in MSME jobs. And in the private sector, hospitals need to be encouraged to provide specific of the isolation ward to the poor and extended family financial assistance on soft terms. Export incentive schemes like Section 10AA for special economic zone units under Income Tax Act that should be extended for one more year, and which we can say up to March 31st, 2021. There should be extended in the import-export policy for one more year. All charges, including port charges, penal charges, various, that should be waived. And in order to have basic in the constituent plans where the economy in the better prepare for a work from home mode, the government should keep half of its GST rates on all laptops, routers, cloud services, dongles, and such other equipment and services. That's why people can get easily benefit from that, and they can work properly in work from home mode. Lastly, it is for all companies that should give CSR funds to excessively in towards creation of clean quarantine centers, addition of hospital beds, ventilators, and PPEs, and besides investing in testing and other facilities aimed to preventing the spread of virus. That these should be maintained, and this should be in focus. We should be made. Thanks for watching.